You guys know the drill. Two penny boxes in front of me, two chances to slot either a Lincoln cent for my Dance Co. Lincoln album or a Canadian small cent for my Canadian small cents albums. Stay tuned for penny hunt and fill number 138, and we have boxes 258 and 259 in front of us. Hey everyone, it's Rob Finds Treasure, and welcome back to my channel. Like I said in the intro, a two-box penny hunt to do today. Now, obviously, it's been a while since we slotted a cent in my Dance Co. Lincoln penny album, but we did get that 1942 King George VI cent for the Canadian album last episode. In front of me are two circulated coin boxes. I already checked them. I can see through the holes in the bottom, and I'm hoping we find some goodies in them. For now, I'm going to slide the books out of the way, and obviously I'll give you guys a look at the books when I compare today's finds to them to see if we have any upgrades or additions. In the meantime, let's crack right into this first box. I actually picked this box up just the other day, so hopefully a fresh box means fresh finds. That box is a little bit older. All right, let's go ahead and see what we got in here, if I can open it, because a fresh box sometimes means a weak box. Holy cow, it's falling apart in my hands. Let me go ahead and bring you guys back in a second. All right, man, they have been gluing my boxes a lot more than normal and near the edge. Normally, they glue them across the middle and you can tear them open easy, but lately, they've gone glue crazy. Either way, it looks like we have a nice circulated penny box. I do see quite a few copper enders in here, so we might have a good copper mix as well. Let's go ahead and start the roll hunt, and I'll bring you guys in when I have my first find, if I have a find, in box number one. Our first wheat cent of the hunt's gonna come in roll number three, and it's gonna be from the 40s. It's a 1946 Philadelphia. We're off and running with the wheat cents. Roll number eight, wheat cent number two. And that's gonna be a 1947 Denver this time. Roll number 12, wheat cent number three, 1944 Philadelphia. Roll number 22, we have four wheat cents now, and that's a 57 Denver. Roll 25 is going to give us our first Canadian cent, and I'm filming it because it's a laureate portrait, so we know it's going to be 1964 or earlier. And that's a 1959. We'll definitely take that. Maybe it's one we need. Roll number 29. We've hit five wheat cents, but it's one we've already found in this hunt. Another 1947 Denver, but in better shape. Roll number 39, we've made it to six wheat cents. Wheat cent number six, and that's gonna be one from the 30s. That's our oldest find so far. Good seeing one from the 30s, although it's a Philadelphia minted common 1935. I'll still take it. Six on the board, 11 rolls plus this to go. The very last roll of box one is gonna give us a parting gift for wheat cent number seven. And that's gonna be a 1946 Denver. Seven wheat cents. Let me finish that roll, and I'll be back with a box recap. Well, we've completed that first box of this two-box penny hunt, and it was light on the wheat cents. We got seven on the board, one from the 30s, which I'll take. I'll also mention that I have found a really nice 1992 Denver. I was hoping it was the close aim, of course, but it wasn't, but I'm going to check it against my personal collection, see if it upgrades. We did get three Canadian cents. One was a laureate portrait from 1959. We got an 01 and a 77. We only got one 1959 out of the whole box and three 1969s, which I'll take. We did net ourselves six beautiful copper cents here, a 1959D, a 62P, a 64P, a 67, a 1971S. It's not the nicest one, but it's an S minted copper cent, and I don't find them too often, and then a really nice 1975 Philly. Speaking of copper, a little bit light, but not bad, 2 pounds, 5 ounces in that first box. Box one is done. Box two will slide over. Hopefully I can open this easily. Feels like it might be a pretty good glue job here. Maybe. All right, I think I can get it. There we go. All right, let's take a quick peek here. I don't see any obvious enders. It does look light on copper though, so it could be a tough copper box, but you never know. All right, let's continue the hunt. We need 13 wheat cents to average 10 for the two-box hunt, and that's what I've been averaging over the course of the last year. Let's get to it. I'll bring you back in with my first find of box number two. Roll number three of box two is going to give us our first wheat cent of the box, an eighth overall. And take a look at it. The infamous 1950 Denver. Need that in my nickels, but we'll take it in the pennies. Same roll. Wheat cent number nine, a 1948 Denver. Roll number 57 of the 100 roll hunt will get us to our 10th wheat cent finally. It's already the third in this box, though. It's a 1945 Denver. Roll 59. Wheat cent 11 is another 1945 Denver. Roll number 60. And 1945 seems to be the year because wheat cent number 12 is a 1945 Philadelphia. Roll number 63. The box is staying hot. Wheat cent number 13. That's a baker's dozen. 1951 Philadelphia. Roll number 65 is going to give us our 14th wheat cent, which means we had 7 in the first 50 rolls of box 1 and 7 again in the first 15 rolls of box number 2. It's reverse facing, so let's see what it is. A 1948 Philadelphia. Roll number 72, we have 15 wheat cents. A 1946 Philadelphia. Same roll, make that 16 wheat cents. A 1952 San Francisco. Roll number 78. We have 17 wheat cents. Wheat cent 17. And that's a 47S. We'll definitely take that one. Roll number 84 is going to give us our 18th wheat cent. Two away from 20. And the 11th of this box. 1948 Denver. Roll 85. Wheat cent number 19. Another 1944 Philly. Roll 86 is going to give us our 20th wheat cent. It's obverse facing, and it's an oldie. Take a look at this. 1919, and I think that's a San Francisco. Definitely looks like it. And it is. Not a much better date, but still a San Francisco minted teens wheat cent, and that's the oldest of the box. 1919S. 20 wheat cents, 13 in the box, 14 rolls still to go, plus this. Roll 88, make it 21 Wheaties. Another 1945 Denver. Roll 93 is going to have a couple of wheat cents for number 22 and 23. We have one on the front. When I flattened out the roll, we have another one, and that one looks like an old reverse. This is a 1948 San Francisco. We'll definitely take San Francisco minted wheat cents all day. And then the one back here, like I said, it looks like it could be old. And it's not, just another 1944. 23 wheat cents so far, 16 in this box. We still have 7 rolls left. Well, that's going to do for the second box of this two-box hunt. And actually, the second box was a dandy of a box. We got a total of 16 wheat cents in box 2 after getting only 7 in box 1. So there's 23 on the board. We do have a 1935 wheat cent and that 1919S. I'm hoping it upgrades. It's not in the best shape, but I don't remember what one looks like in the book. On top of that, I said the copper might not have been that good in that box. It didn't look like it was going to be great, and we did just fine. 5 pounds, 2 ounces, so almost 3 pounds in the second box. We'll definitely take over 5 pounds of copper any day of the week. As far as Canadian cents, we ended with 4. We also got 4 1959s and a total of 6 1969 S's. I don't see those very often in my hunts, so it was good to see them, although none of the DDO. Speaking of copper, take a look at all these nice copper cents. A lot of different years in here. I've covered some of them already, but I went ahead and kept some of the nicer ones. And even the ones that aren't as nice overall, I like the toning on them, or I like the reflectivity of them. That being said, we do need to go through all the wheat cents we found and the Canadian cents we found to compare them to the books to see if we have possibly any upgrades or additions. So let me go ahead and do that now, and I'll bring you back with a look at the books and some final thoughts on today's two-box hunt. Well, I've compared all of today's finds to both albums, and despite the sheer number of beautiful red copper cents, I was only able to make a case to upgrade to the 1967 and the 1975. Outside of that, the rest were either equal or slightly better in the book, so I figured I'd just leave them as they are. We did not add at 1919S either because I have a pretty decent one in the book compared to the one I found. On top of that, despite finding 4 Canadian cents, we had all 4 already in the Canadian cent album. So now, after 259 boxes searched, We're stuck at 208 of the 234 cents in the Lincoln Dansko penny album, and we're stuck at 62 of the 115 cents found after 73 boxes in the Canadian small cents albums. At the end of the day, it was still a really fun hunt. I got 23 wheat cents in two boxes, 5 pounds of copper, a few oldies, and some nice copper red cents to add to the collection, and that always makes me happy. Hopefully, even though we didn't add anything to either of the books, you guys still enjoyed this two-box hunt, and if you did, I'd appreciate that thumbs up. And as always, everyone, happy hunting, and thanks for watching.